Welcome to part 5 and the final lesson of how to control a VFD with a PLC. We have created this series of lessons discussing the steps to configure and program communication between a Rockwell ControlLogix PLC and a Siemens VFD. As a prerequisite, please watch lessons 1 through 4. We have provided the links to these lessons in the description area. Here at RealPars, we love making videos that help you to discover new and exciting topics. So if you enjoy viewing this video as much as we enjoyed making it, click the like button below. Remember to click subscribe and the little bell, and you'll receive notifications of new RealPars videos when they become available. So you'll never miss another one. In part 5, this video, we will pick up where we left off in part 4 to complete the VFD configuration and the communication path between the gateway and the Rockwell ControlLogix processor. In the previous part, I left off right after completing the motor and its nameplate data configuration. Let's pick up from the last step of the motor configuration, where we had configured the important parameters of the motor. In the important parameters display, as you can see, I set some of the important parameters according to the motor's data sheet. I continued by selecting the Next button, and the pump configuration summary display appeared. I selected the Finish button to continue. Over the next few steps, we will be configuring the parameters we used in parts 1 and 2 to allow the VFD to communicate with the ControlLogix 5000 PLC. You can learn more about the VFD parameters and their usage via the Synamics S120, S150 manual. We've put the link to this manual in the description if you're watching this video on YouTube or any other social media platform. Now, under the Drives folder, I expand the RealPars Drive 1. Then I double-click on Communication Item. Within the Receive Direction tab, I will click into the PZD2 and click in the white area next to the hex box. Then I open the RealPars Drive 1 menu to select P1070, the main set point. Next, under the Transmit Direction tab, I will enter a few more parameters. First, I click into the PZD1. Then I locate R20890, the Send Binector Connector Converter status word 1, and select it by clicking on it. If you open the Synamics S120, S150 parameter manual and search for the R20890, you will find out where the ZSW word naming derives from. From previous parts of this video series, you can remember the ZSW1 status words in the spreadsheet, which were sent from the Siemens VFD toward the Rockwell PLC via the HMS Anybus gateway. I will complete the remaining entries here in the Transmit Direction tab. I click into the PZD2, then I select Further Interconnections. I locate R630, the actual speed value unsmoothed entry, which represents the NACT communication tag from the spreadsheet. Then I hit OK. I click into the PZD3. I open the RealPars Drive 1 menu to locate R680, the absolute current actual value unsmoothed. This is the IAC tag from the spreadsheet. I then select it by clicking on it. For the next word, I click into the PZD4. Then I select Further Interconnections. I scroll down until I select R80, the torque actual value unsmoothed. It is the MACT tag from the spreadsheet. To continue, I hit OK. I click into the PZD5, then I select Further Interconnections. I find and expand R630. Then I select R631, the actual speed value smoothed, with P0045. This parameter represents the NACT smooth communication tag from the list. To continue, I press OK. I click into the PZD6. Then I open the RealPars Drive 1 menu to locate R681, the absolute current actual value smoothed with P0045. This word represents the IACT smooth from the spreadsheet tags. I select it by clicking on it. I click into the PZD7. Then I select Further Interconnections. I scroll down to find and expand R80. Then I select R81, the torque actual value smoothed with P0045. This entry represents the MACT smooth communication tag name. To continue, I hit OK. Finally, for the last parameter, I click into the PZD8, then I select Further Interconnections. I scroll down to find and expand R820. Then I select R821, the active power actual value smoothed with P0045. This entry represents the PACT smooth communication tag. To continue, I press OK. Now, on the final tab, by Nectar Connector Converter, you can see that the first slot, Status Word 1 Sources, automatically changes to P2051-0. We have completed the configuration of the PZD, or Process Data Interface Selection, for Profibus communication to the HMS module. This concludes the last video of this series, ControlLogix PLC and Siemens VFD Communication, Part 5. I hope you've enjoyed learning what will support you in your upcoming project. Want to learn PLC programming in an easy-to-understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realpars.com.